making plans with each other. It looks real good on you. For it, I didn't come to make things strange. Cause there's a reason that things change. There's nothing we can do. And it's been 5 long years since I've seen your lovely eyes. Your girl's out the road, she sees right through my thin disguise. You know I can love you, you know I'd never change. And it's been 5 long years and I love you just the same.
On my first album, I've got a lot of different influences in it because I have played, you know, bluegrass and country and different styles of music. I love the old stuff a lot, so I do the Chicago blues and stuff like that, which I love. I mean, it's very something I love deeply. But when I write music, it often comes out different, and I can never really say what it's gonna be before I do it. It's the 5 long years, for instance, is a pop song, blatant pop song. With honest lyrics, and Dream of Satin is a pop ballad. Then I'll turn around and do a Howlin' Wolf cover, or I'll write one like I wrote in Lone Wolf, which is like a 40s big band swing song. I like the variance in it. It lets me have a lot of freedom. I think a lot of people would argue that it's good to have a lot of straight ahead continuity on a record. I'm personally really pleased with the variance on it.
Cigars and the third row. Cigars and the third row. with the whoa. Gypsy cars and a third row, 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 whoa. They sounded three things with a little foreign. Cars and the third world war.
I tried a lot of different things over the years. I mean, when I quit school, or I got kicked out of school, in grade 10, I moved to Winnipeg, I moved to Montreal, played on the street in Montreal, moved to Saskatoon, taught music in Indian reserves up in northern Saskatchewan. I really just kept on moving to keep things going, because if I stayed in one place, I'd get stagnant and things wouldn't happen. I really had to run around and keep things going, you know? And eventually I moved to Vancouver on a train. I consider this home now. It's a beautiful place. I came off the Stevie Ray Vaughan tour. I had sold my acoustic and my amplifier. I had no money. My rent was due. I was in a pretty bad state where I met my manager, Steve Macklin.
Well, I wish I could take credit for finding Colin, but I think really the credit would have to go to Stevie Ray Vaughan if it went to anybody who discovered him in Regina. And my partner also, Larry, saw him playing in Alberta with an entertainer called Billy Cowsill. And I came in a little late on the game, because when I found him, he was already playing in front of the liquor store on Broadway in Arbutus.
The best day I ever did is I made a bag of blueberries, a beer, $50, and a ticket to Simon Garfunkel. But I had to scalp the ticket to Simon Garfunkel because I was broke. Yeah.
Apparently were taking him to folk festivals from a very early age. I've seen pictures of him playing mandolin when he was that tall on these folk stages. So he was subjected to blues and folk music and foot massage and all that sort of thing when the rest of us were banging our heads to Led Zeppelin or whatever. So his background was more ethnic, and he seemed to come up through that community. And with the Quaker background that he had and everything, it created a very different kind of personality, not as bent on succeeding in the purely commercial sense of rock, more an honest interest in the roots of music and playing it. And people have, as long as I've known him, and I'm sure for years before I met him, have always been saying to him, where the hell did you learn to play like that? Where did you, how did you get to do that? I mean, you're just a white kid from Regina.
Nowadays, we're all inundated by radio and stuff from a very young age. I grew up with rock and roll, and, you know, and with blues through my parents. But blues is in all kinds of music, and it's in jazz, it's in R&B, it's in pop, it's in rock and roll. It's a great basis for any musician to start playing from, no matter whether you've lived it or not.
Well, I'm a mighty, mighty man, I'm young and I'm in my prime. Well, I'm a mighty, mighty man, I'm young and I'm in my prime. You see me holler, I'll be there on time. Seven, I ain't no hammer down. Well, I'm 5'7", I ain't no hammer down. 5'7", got the best down in town. Yeah, when the work to be done, just send for the mighty one. When the work to be done, just send for the mighty one. We'll stay on the job till that job is done. Yeah, you know what job I'm talking about. Names. Got a brand new gal, call me good or rockin' James. Come on, Johnny, lay it on me. We'll be right back.
like I do. No one knows Atlanta like I do. The reason I know her is I traveled her through and through.
Home means a lot more to me right now than I think it ever did. Because before, I mean, it was a place where I was at too much. I didn't have enough to do, and I was living day to day, and wait until I was busy all the time. Wait until I always had things to do. Now I always do have things to do, and I'm home. This last couple months, I've been home like 3 days out of the whole time, and so all the more to me now is just a place for me to come and collect my thoughts, and get in touch with myself. Just a place to calm down for, if I can, for 3-4 days, maybe 5 days. It's a very grounding thing.
Well, the sun's gonna shine in my back door someday. I'm gonna run in the target. It's gonna shine in my back door someday. And the wind's gonna blow, it's gonna blow it all.
Yeah, it's been a very crazy year, you know. Before I didn't have to do a lot of this stuff. I just moved from town to town and do what I do. In the last year, it's been contracts and lawyers and percentages, high-pressure shows where I never had that kind of pressure on me before. It's changed me in the way that I'm probably not as happy and go-lucky as I once was. I'm trying not to get jaded. A lot more pressure is just maybe probably more mature. This is going to end tomorrow. I've just, in the last couple of years, I've fulfilled a lot of things and done a lot of things I never thought or really dreamed that I'd be able to do. I mean, with the record contract and playing in New York and Los Angeles and places like that, and working with a lot of great people. And surrounded in my camp are a lot of really good people with the band and the management and everybody. I'd just like to be remembered as someone who took a shot at in the music business and, you know, got somewhere from a place like Regina, Saskatchewan, and I hope that can affect some younger musicians in general, but you know, people growing up in smaller places, that you can get out. You don't have to necessarily go to the States, but you can get out and make it in the world. No matter where you're from, no matter what you do, you can make it if you try. We'll be right back.
a very unusual way of playing the guitar. And, well, as you may notice, he's got the guitar across his knees and he's sitting down. And as you may not know, he uses all five of his, what normally would be fret fingers, to play different kinds of vibrato, and he does a lot of bending with his thumb, and I'm talking about him like he's not here, right? Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very unique musician, Mr. Jeff Healy, and he's going to play a song called See the Light. Jeff?
good talking to this town.